Okay, we're back again, and today we're joined by the incredible and multi-talented musician and singer-songwriter, Ryan Sheridan. How are you doing, Ryan?
Good, Cal. How are you?
Not too bad at all, no. It's been lovely over the last few days to be able to talk to so many musicians and people in the entertainment industry that have had no work over the last 18 months. So yeah. What's it been like for you?
It's been different. That's for sure. We haven't been as active, obviously. I think it was February was the last gig we had last year. So, but we had to change up a few things. Like, I started producing stuff as well, and I worked on an album, and I kept myself busy. I built a studio here and started working on different stuff, and just kept myself busy, really, you know?
Yeah, yeah. And as you said, you've been busy writing. You have a brand new single out at the moment. It's called Fine Wine.
I do. It's been a while.
Yeah. So let's have a listen to that before we talk about it. Yeah, life's a fine wine, bittersweet from time to time, but tastes much better with you. Then the band stands up, plays your favorite tune. All right, so that's your brand new single, Fine Wine. Yeah. Was that written over the last couple of months?
It was, yeah. And to be honest, I was delighted that I actually finished something, you know, because it wasn't a great year for trying to write stuff, you know. So I was just absolutely over the moon that I actually finished something. Mm. So it was written over the past couple of months and finished off. And I says, right, we'll just release it. And so.
Do you find it hard when there's not as much going on in the world, I suppose, to find inspiration to write?
Yeah, there was nothing, you know, you're not out and about, you're not taking in, you know, you're not. It's all doom and gloom in most parts. But you're not out and about. Usually it's easier when you're out touring and you're, you know, taking in inspiration from different people and stuff like that there. So. But yeah, no, I'm delighted I got something finished, you know?
Yeah, exactly. And that new single, will that be taken from a new upcoming album? Can we expect some more music later on this year?
I've actually finished off, I've done a country, American kind of Americana album over the lockdown. So that will be coming out first. And this will be a part of an album, yes, but it won't be. I have to release this other album first, so I'm excited about it. Also, it's songs that I've wanted to cover and you know, that kind of style, Americana style, and you know, so I'm very happy with that as well. So I kept myself busy, you know.
Yeah, yeah. I want to remind our viewers of just a few of your older songs. One of my favorites, we'll talk about it after. This is Home. No one said it was easy on your own. We learned the hard way, it seems, chasing dreams, running miles from where you're from. That's yourself with Home. Can you remember what year that was brought out?
That would have been 2015, I think.
Was it? Yeah, one of my favorite songs from that year. Just and do you know what I love about that video is it nearly resonates more with people now, just for the fact that people couldn't travel and people have been stuck, you know, abroad and all that kind of thing. Like so, you know, yeah. Are you kind of happy that the video still has so much meaning to people who haven't been home in so long?
Absolutely. I mean, that's the thing about music, really, isn't it? You never know when the song will pop up again or anything like that. So. And that's exactly what the song was written about. So it's what you miss from home, or you know, and stuff like that. So yeah, great to see it again.
Have you been busy over the last while, kind of rehearsing and getting yourself together for upcoming gigs in front of people?
We have. Myself and Ronan, there's just the two of us, so it's been a while, but we just sit back into it, you know. There's not that many of us in the band, so it's not that, but we just sit back into it, and you know, but it has been strange playing again and even singing again as well, to be honest. You know, it's been a full year and a half, and so just dusting off the cobwebs and trying out new stuff, trying out new songs, and but I'm really looking forward to it. I can't explain how much I'm looking forward to playing this gig live.
What's it going to feel like when you're playing in front of an actual audience again? Because it's been so long since you've got that reaction. Yeah.
I don't know. I'd be playing songs and, you know, in front of my family here, and that's about the height of it. So
yeah.
I don't know why it's going to be. It's going to be great. It's going to be absolutely phenomenal. We're going to make, you know, there'll be loads of energy for it. Loads of energy on stage for it, definitely. So if we can give that off and get it back, then it's going to be ahead of the gig. So
did you do much of the kind of live streams and stuff over the last while, or did you stay away from it?
I did it at the start. I'd done a few, but then I kind of just stayed away from it. I got my head down and other stuff, and writing and recording, and more recording even, just producing stuff. I kind of went that direction, kept myself busy, you know.
So,
not too many streams, but
do you have a date, by the way, for that new album? The kind of Americana album.
The Americana album is not going to be released until next year.
Next year, yeah.
So, but I keep busy. There's going to be new songs coming out in the meantime.
And as well, obviously, you're going to be playing here on the 13th of August, Friday the 13th, which is, I don't know, is it a good or a bad day to be doing a gig? Hopefully good.
I don't know.
Are you superstitious?
No, I'm not really. No, I'm not really. Friday the 13th.
That's okay.
Be good energy.
As long as it doesn't rain. Although, to be honest, most of the people here will be covered. So it's only the people that come in late at the back that might get a small bit wet if it rains. So you'll be all right. What's the plan going forward? Have you much more of these kind of shows, or are you going to be quiet until things come back to a small bit more normal?
I think we've got a few more Irish dates around to be announced up through September. And then we don't know what's happening after that, but there's a good 6 or 7 dates there. And then maybe European tour next year. It's not until next year. So between that, I don't know what's gonna happen. Nobody does, I suppose.
What are you looking forward to most? Being back on the road and playing in front of people again.
I love touring. I love traveling. I love different venues. I love different meeting different people, and you know, having each gig just being different every single night. You know, that's what I miss the most. I miss the traveling the most. I miss the different people in the different places, and the different stories, the different heckling, the different energies. That's what I miss. The most, and that's why I do it. That's why I play live, to be honest. That's the main drug.
Yeah. And people that have seen you live before and heard your music, like, you're incredibly gifted on guitar, as in, and I'd say people are kind of in awe of just how fast you can play as well. So, like, have people inspired you to play that way, or is it something you kind of grew into yourself over time?
I wouldn't really consider myself a guitar player at all. I'm more of a percussionist, maybe. I don't know. When I went busking, when I started this journey, I suppose, I was busking first of all. And I was busking with a cajon player, and he was already playing on the street, and he was really fast, and he was, you know, just really sharp and everything. And I when we started playing together, I kind of had to keep up with him. And that's kind of where it kind of started. And I have an Irish traditional background as well. So I played the fiddle. I started on the fiddle. I played in the Kyotas for years, and as an Irish dancer and everything like that. So I think all them rhythms and stuff just kind of, it sat into the kind of music that I was trying to do, and we just took it from there and just kept going with it. It kind of seemed like an original sound, and kind of just kept with it, and that's really what it was. Nobody really inspired me to start playing that way. I think I just had to keep up with the other players.
I suppose people might be surprised to hear that you're an Irish dancer, because it's not something people would know about you.
You don't know I have a physique. You have a dancer's physique, Cal. Everybody should know.
So did you keep yourself, were you dancing through lockdown as well as well as playing music?
I tell you, it's been a while now since I started dancing, I have to say. I was in Riverdance when it started, kind of first for years. For about 5 years, I think, toured around the States and went to Broadway and everything. So that was a big part of my life as well. But it was kind of there that I really knew that I wanted to perform. I didn't know what way I was going to perform, because I wasn't really playing the guitar at that stage or singing. I didn't know I could sing at that stage or try to sing even. But it was definitely something that I wanted to do. I wanted to be on stage. And it was kind of there that kind of set me up for everything else. So
And I suppose even the first time you got reactions from audiences, was that just through Irish dancing as well? It's probably addictive as well to want to stay on stage, be it dancing or be it playing music.
That's the drug. It's the energy in the room is, no matter what you do, that's what holds you there. So that's what keeps coming back, and I'm lucky enough to be able to bring this forward now with the music.
There's plenty room if you want to have a dance. Although
I'll bring the shoes.
Bring the shoes, but do you know what? I don't think you're allowed to dance. You have to stay in your seats and everything. So
maybe next time. You can dance on the table. It is your pod.
As long as you're in your pod, I'm sure you'll be able to dance together. But I don't know. Yeah. I don't know how it's going to work. But for next time, we can do it. We'll have to stick people to the table this time round. But it's been lovely to talk to you, Ryan. You're here with us the 13th of August, and it's going to be a great night. It's going to be Irish music again, which is something we're all craving. I'm sure you're craving to get back on stage as well.
Absolutely. I can't wait for it. I can't wait for it now. It's been too long, Cal. It's been too long. I'm delighted to be
long.
Back then, Cal.
Yeah. And hopefully we never have to say goodbye to it again. All going well.